Welcome. I'm Mary Winters, and today I will be interviewing Regina Faulkerson. She's the Assistant Inspector in Charge for the U.S. Postal Inspection Service. So welcome. Thank you for coming today.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So tell me a little bit about what a U.S. Postal Inspector does.
The United States Postal Inspection Service, we're the law enforcement arm for the Postal Service. We're responsible for enforcing more than 200 federal laws. Postal inspectors, we work crimes, we're the investigative end of it. We work crimes such as mail theft, fraud, child exploitation, dangerous and illegal drugs coming through the mail. So we work a lot of stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. Very interesting. Yeah. Well, there's a special thing that we want to address today, and we want to look and discuss a little bit about foreign lottery fraud.
Absolutely.
So let's talk about that a little bit in conjunction with your national program that you are launching, and that's the National Consumer Protection Week. And so let's go into a little more detail about how some of these lotteries take place and how they're so prevalent, and I think in particular they seem to really focus on our seniors.
Yes.
And they're lonely. Yeah. They may have nobody watching out for them.
Right.
They are may have some cognitive issues. So they're kind of perfect prey, aren't they?
They are. You're right. You know, National Consumer Protection Week usually happens right around the first week of March every year. Okay. It's a collaboration with local, state, and federal agencies. It's our prevention push for the agencies. And this year we are focusing on foreign lottery fraud. You know, typically it's just that week, but the Los Angeles division will host it for the next month. We have prevention efforts throughout the month. We're gonna be at senior centers, we're gonna be at various community groups, so we will be making presentations throughout the month.
Good, that's important. So. There is a lot of money that is frauded on individuals with these scams. What is it, about $42 million in loss?
Yeah, about $42 million, and we believe that most of that is unreported because seniors are usually, or older Americans are usually ashamed and embarrassed that they've been scammed, and oftentimes they don't report it.
It's actually not uncommon with all types of elder abuse for it to go unreported.
Yeah.
And so I think there's some things that we need to really identify as family members and neighbors. What are some of the things we want to really look out for when we need to be aware? So
exactly.
We want to become suspicious of some of the behaviors of our seniors, maybe. What kinds of things do we look for, changes maybe in their personality, that we should be a little concerned about and think maybe there's a lottery scam going on here?
Well, let me tell you first how the foreign lottery scam works.
Okay.
Victims are contacted either by telephone, email, or mail. And they're told that, look, you've won a lottery. And so these people are expecting some type of a prize, but in order to receive the prize, they have to send money to pay for either taxes or fees of some kind. Oftentimes, there's no lottery. These people are looking for opportunities to build a relationship with these people, with the victims. And once they develop that relationship, Mary, the victims find it very difficult to think that they've been duped.
So, Inspector, tell me the difference between a legal lottery and one that is illegal.
Well, first off, federal statute prohibits the mailing of foreign lottery mailings. Now, a state, there are some exemptions.
Okay.
For example, a state mailing a lottery mailing, they can do that as long as the state authorizes it within that state or within the U.S. So there are exemptions to it.
And there are ways to find out and confirm that they are legitimate, I'm
absolutely.
Assuming. Okay.
Absolutely. You can contact the Postal Inspection Service for that. You can contact us on our website at postalinspectors.uspis.gov to find that information out. You can also contact the Attorney General's office to find out if your state is actually sending out legitimate mailings.
Okay. So. I want people to get their pens and their paper together. Mm-hmm. You just announced the website. We're going to say this a few times along with some other information that we want people to write down, because we want people to be protected and we want people to be aware.
Right.
So go back into how some of these fraudulent foreign lottery
scams work. Well, Mary, first off, I want your viewers to understand that older Americans can lose their life savings with these foreign lotteries, because these scammers view them as being extremely vulnerable. And oftentimes, as I said earlier, these scams go unreported. So we know that there are more victims out there who are just not reporting this information. Mm-hmm. And any legitimate lottery will not contact you and tell you that you won.
Okay.
You know, oftentimes, if you've won a foreign lottery, if you didn't put in or didn't play, you didn't win. So that's what we want people to keep that in mind. If you didn't participate, you didn't win.
Right. So it's common sense, but somebody who may have a little issue with their cognitive functioning may not relate to that, or have a background of maybe gambling, or maybe a little more susceptible to some of these issues.
Yes, and that's why they target older Americans, because they do see them as being vulnerable.
Okay. So let's talk a little bit maybe about an example of a senior that you have been able to protect, or a case that you were able to prosecute.
Right. You know, we've had the inspection service, we've been working these cases, because elderly, this type of scam is growing so rapidly at this point. So we had one example that I would like to share with you here in Southern California. One of my inspectors went out to a home. She was investigating something, a foreign lottery, actually. She had gone out there and wanted to talk to the couple. She get in the house and she sees all these solicitations, all these mailings, sweepstakes, tons of mail. So she starts talking to the couple and she's asking them questions relative to the mailings that she's seen. The couple tells her that they just lost their oldest daughter. Mm. She passed away. And they also tell her that they've been sending money out of the country. And so she started asking questions about it. And it's the woman, the wife, she started saying that, you know, well, I want to stop this. I know that we're sending money out and we probably shouldn't be sending money out.
That's what I think is very interesting, is people, their common sense tells them that it's probably not the right thing. But it's my understanding that they just don't know how to stop, or they just, there's something inside of them that says this is the right thing to do, so they keep doing it.
Yeah, well, in this case, her husband pressured her and said, we need to continue to send money. Well, they sold their cars because they ran out of money. They their cars to get money, to continue sending the money to wherever they were sending it. Eventually, they sold their home. They were lucky because the person who bought their home allowed them to rent the house from them. So they sold their home to continue the scheme, thinking that they would win millions.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So the retirement was gone.
Everything was gone, Mary. And that's what we're trying to get out to the American public. You can lose everything from these scams.
Mm-hmm.
And if you think that you've been a victim, or you know someone who has been a victim, report it, because so often they go unreported.
And it's my understanding you're really not able to recover these lost funds.
No, oftentimes we can't. You know, once this money goes out of the country, it's very difficult to get the money back. Now, I will tell you, the Postal Inspection Service is working very hard to prosecute these people, but it makes it very difficult once that money is either mailed out or wired out of the country using Western Union. It's very difficult.
Okay, so let's talk about the complexity of how these scams are operated. Through the internet, an internet kind of phone system, how are they doing?
Yes. The interesting thing is these scammers use a lot of different technology, and the technology is constantly changing. One way that they develop relationships with people is through the internet. And they use the telephone and the internet. They can contact a victim and have extended conversations with them. That's how they develop that relationship with them, and they develop a rapport, which makes it very difficult for the victim to decide whether or not they're a friend or foe. So it makes it really difficult. They also have internet mapping, where they use it as a form of intimidation. So when the money has run out, they contact you and say, look, we need more money. You say, I don't have any more money. Then they use this mapping, internet mapping system, where they can identify where you live, the neighbor's house, give descriptions of vehicles in the area, and basically tell you that if you don't send any more money, I'm going to send somebody to your house. So now you're lonely, you're at home.
That's terrifying.
What do you think?
That's absolutely terrifying.
Yeah. And that's what they look to do.
I'm sorry, but I actually became involved, Inspector, in a case where that very thing happened. Mm-hmm. The gentleman went to a neighbor finally to beg for some additional funds. That is when the issue was uncovered, and he was then taken into protection. But it's frightening to the lengths that they'll go to.
Right.
And you mentioned using the internet, but they're actually using a system that works over your phone.
Right.
So many of our seniors don't have internet systems set up, or they use
exactly.
a computer, but they can still access their phone through these internet systems.
Yeah, it's called
correct?
Voice over internet protocol.
Okay,
is what it's called. And yes, there's access to that. You know, it's more available than I think the older Americans know about. But that's the key. We want to educate everybody about these different types of scams, so that, because again, that's the best form of the defense. I mean, it's if you know about it.
But they're friendly, and they're savvy, and they're persistent, and it doesn't matter to them what they take from you. I think a trusting senior who is alone is extremely susceptible because they have maybe nobody visiting, or they have a lot of free time on their hands. And so you have an individual who sounds very friendly on the other side of the phone, and there you go, $5 here. What does it usually start with?
About $15.
Okay.
Usually what happens is you get a solicitation through the mail, and the solicitation, again, tells you that you're a winner. You're going to win millions of dollars. All you have to do is send $15, either cash, mail the cash, or wire the money, and you're a winner, or you're put on a list to become a winner. And there's no lottery.
So that's a true sign of fraud.
That
you don't
is.
Ask for
that
money
is.
To be part of the
lottery.
The lottery. Mm-hmm. That is an indicator. If they're asking for money up front,
absolutely.
It's a fraud.
Absolutely. If they're asking for money up front, if they're also applying pressure pitches to you, mm-hmm. you know, you know if somebody's pressuring you to make a decision right now, mm-hmm. a legitimate company will give you the opportunity to decide. These people are not are not giving you that opportunity.
No.
They want an answer, they want it now, they want the money right now.
I've actually empowered some of our seniors by allowing them to tell their own little white lies and to say that you have that son that will be checking in, even if they don't exist.
Right.
My neighbor checks in on me routinely, so I think I will ask them first. Allow them to have that little out to say, I'm not sure about you.
Right.
And I think sometimes if they think they're going to get caught, are they less likely to continue to pursue you, or are they still that invasive, that domineering to still get those phone calls through?
I think these scammers are extremely aggressive, is what we've seen, based on some of the investigations that we've conducted. They're extremely aggressive, and they don't think that they're going to get caught. As long as seniors continue to send money, cash through the mail, or wire the money to these fraudsters, they're not going to stop.
So it starts at 15, then what do you start seeing it increase to?
It starts increasing. Once you send them that money, they're going to keep contacting you. It's not going to stop. They're going to keep contacting you, and it may get more and more aggressive. And before long, you have a situation like I told you earlier, in which you're losing your life savings.
Mm-hmm. And it's unrecoverable.
It is.
So I know even social workers and nurses and home care providers will go into the house. I think those are things that they need to look out for as well.
Right.
But it sounds like lots of mail may be coming. So if you're checking the mail for someone, that's a key indicator then as well.
Absolutely. If you're checking the mail for someone, one of the indicators, a lot of solicitations, a lot of sweepstakes, a lot of lottery mail, in addition to if you are a caretaker, please take the time and ask questions. Go in and look at their financial statements. If you see a lot of cash going out to an unknown location, ask questions about it, because I think it's important for the caretaker to take a vested interest in what's going on in that person's life, because again, they can be saving them from losing their life savings.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. So looking at the mail, if you have access to bank statements to mm-hmm. look at some of those things, are you seeing that they're typically sending cash until it gets to a certain point
though?
Oh,
yes, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay,
for
so
the most
you may
part,
not know unless you see the mail.
Absolutely. For the most part, they're asked to send cash by the via mail or wire the funds using Western Union of some sort.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Is there a way to track that with Western Union at all, or to know your, I guess you can't necessarily know your local Western Union station, but something that can be investigated or maybe touch base with?
Yeah, as postal inspectors, we work with local and other state agencies. So we collaborate with them to try to find these people who are scamming the older Americans. We really do. So there are means that that we take to try to locate them.
Wow. Mm-hmm. So how many scams do you think are running at any given time? I mean, it's just uncertain.
Mary, it's so many. I mean, these people, again, they're targeting the elderly, and unfortunately, I cannot, you know, quantify exactly how many there are, but it's a lot of them that we're dealing with.
And from my experience, mm-hmm. they're actually very educated, sophisticated seniors, and they really are very crafty in the way they present their story to seem like it's very normal to ask what they're asking for. And when you trust someone or you think that this is probably a pretty easy little lump sum of money I can produce for myself, and you're living off of Social Security,
right.
It looks kind of promising sometimes.
It does. I mean, someone's promising you millions. You know, we recommend that if someone calls you and tell you that you are a winner of a lottery, of a foreign lottery, hang up the phone. That's one of the big things. Just hang up the phone.
Okay. And you have a phone number. I'm going to give this
we
phone
do.
Number out a couple times, actually. It's 877-876-2455. So if they call the senior, an individual, mm-hmm. they can call that number, or we'll give the website address again also, and reach out to them and communicate. So what would they say? I just received a phone call. Walk me through what that senior would need to say.
That 877 number allows you to make a complaint, to file a complaint. We also have another website. It's www.deliveringtrust.com. That website you can go to and find out more about foreign lottery scams and tips and ways to prevent it. So that's also a good one for your viewers.
Okay, you brought me this Delivering Justice, a video.
Yes.
And if somebody wants access to this video, it's free, is my understanding.
Yes, we can have it sent to them.
All
yes.
right, that sounds great. Mm-hmm. And so it provides some examples, some right. real live examples of situations. And I can't express enough how many seniors I've come across who are really pillars of our community,
right.
very knowledgeable, and so easily duped, and you don't even have to be a senior
That's
to
true.
Be duped.
That's true.
They're just so sophisticated,
right.
and it's embarrassing, so people don't want to acknowledge the issue.
It's very underreported, and you're absolutely right. You don't have to be an older American. There have been some educated professors who have also fallen prey to this type of scam. So it's just not the older Americans. However, the foreign lottery scams are targeting our elderly, mm-hmm. and because they do view them as being extremely vulnerable. So,
and it's interesting too, because it's my understanding that some of these old statutes are from like the late 1800s, 1872.
Oh, yeah.
And so we're still not necessarily catching up with the technology, but our mail system really helps us to pin these fellas
right.
down.
Right.
Is there anything new in the works that we should know about or support our local legislature, our politicians, that we make sure that some additional things are put in place? Or
the biggest thing I can tell you and your viewers that can help us is don't become a victim of these foreign lottery scams. We want you to be as educated as possible, and hopefully you will take the time to go to our website, take a look at the DVDs that we have online, and call us if you feel like you've been a victim. Please give the postal inspectors a call.
Okay,
and
Inspector,
hopefully we can help you.
What is the email address or the website address again?
The website address for making a complaint is postalinspectors.uspis.gov if you want to file a complaint. If you want more information and tips on how to prevent yourself from becoming a victim of foreign lottery fraud, contact us at deliveringtrust.com. Again, that's deliveringtrust.com.
Okay, fantastic. And would I expect an inspector to come to my door ever, or how would they reach back out to me to get more details if I was to file a complaint?
I think first you file a complaint, and you will receive a call from an inspector trying to get more information from you. And then from there, we will see exactly what's out there. If in fact, we need more information, an inspector will come out there.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I think it's so difficult sometimes to understand where to go.
Right.
Because it just seems so out there. It's foreign.
Yeah.
You don't go to those governments or those countries and say, hey, why is this person soliciting me?
Right.
So this is wonderful to be able to target and go to a very specific location, get that number, get that website address,
right,
and know that you can communicate with somebody who is behind the phone.
Absolutely.
Or at the agency, and that they'll take care of something like
Absolutely.
That.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. So tell me a little bit more about what you'll be doing within this month, within the week for awareness.
You know, Mary, we have a lot of things lined up. We're going out, as I mentioned earlier, we're going out to a lot of the senior facilities. We're making presentations. We're just educating the consumers about this type of scam and to make them more aware so they can help us and we can help them, because education is the key and prevention is a huge part of that. So
is it assisting at all when you're going to some of these senior centers? They're actually giving you additional information of scams you may not have known about, and they can really support the effort to a certain extent?
I think when we go out to these facilities, the people are very much appreciated. They accept what our inspectors are telling them, mm-hmm. and oftentimes, like with foreign lottery fraud, they don't know that foreign lottery mail is illegal. They don't know. So, I mean, it's good to get the information out. And again, education and prevention is a huge part of that.
Okay. So what makes the foreign lottery fraud illegal? I mean, we know they're trying to scam, but what creates the illegality of the process?
Federal laws prohibit foreign lottery mailings to come into the United States. We have a statute. It's our postal statute, and it's 18 U.S.C. 1302.
Okay.
Prohibits the mailings.
And that's how we're able to get them.
That's it.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking also that some of these scams are coming from certain countries as well.
Yes, they are.
Are you seeing like Australian, the Powerball, are there some others that you're seeing are very common?
Yes, we are. We're seeing them from Canada, Jamaica, Australia. In fact, I have an example for you if you want to show your viewers at all.
Sure, why not? Absolutely. It's kind of interesting because I think everybody sends something a little bit different.
Right.
You're probably a winner, mm-hmm. winner. So we have acknowledgement of order receipt.
Absolutely.
We have the USA Powerball.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a guarantee. Oh, so it's a guarantee prize. So these are the kinds of things that they're sending to people with rules of your prize guarantee. So they even created their own rules in
Absolutely.
Relation to these scams, which I think is very interesting. They have boundaries that they want to create for us, but they have no boundaries themselves.
Right.
So, and I would imagine once you get involved in one, you're getting many of these. Do they share this information?
They share the information.
Kind of like a telemarketing kind of a thing.
That's exactly what it is.
Okay.
Once you send your money for this, mm-hmm. your name is on a list, and you're going to continue to get more solicitations, and they're going to continue to ask you for more money. And the prizes become bigger and bigger each time. So, you know, if you receive something like this, you have our address. We want you to send it to the Postal Inspection Service, Criminal Investigative Service Center in our Chicago, Illinois area. So
okay.
I think you have that address.
In fact, I do have that address.
Yeah.
They have the Criminal Investigation Service Center, mm-hmm. and that would be Attention Mail Fraud. And the address for that is 433 West Harrison Street, room 3255. That is in Chicago, Illinois, with a zip code of 60699-3255. And let me give you the phone number again, too, because I think it's very important to be armed with what you can do to protect yourself, protect your loved ones. The phone number is 877-876-2455. And just kind of going back to the demeanor, the changes that we might see in a senior, we usually see that they may become more reserved.
Mm-hmm.
They don't want to talk about something.
Right.
They're embarrassed. And I think we need to really make sure that we're, as caregivers and neighbors and loved ones, that we are watching their stacks of mail.
That's right.
And that we are also, if we have the ability, to look at what's happening with their bank accounts.
Right.
And if we're seeing lots of unusual activity. I understand, too, they may see many deposits because they get these kind of bogus checks that will eventually bounce.
Right, which you will see with by looking at their financial statements and so forth.
Yeah.
But yes, that's very important because, like I said earlier, the caretakers are the first line of defense. They're the ones who are there. They see it. You have to talk to the victims, engage them.
But if we're not aware of what is happening, then we cannot support or derail some of these issues for them. So I'm really glad that you're addressing this issue. Again, the phone number is 877-876-2455. And Inspector, thank you very much for being with us today.
Thank you, Mary, for having me.
Absolutely. Thanks.